Hello everyone, welcome to the TSS. So in this class we will discuss about the HTML attributes. So what are attributes? Attributes are the special additional information to the browser, okay? So special instructions to the browser in addition to the basic tag fields, okay? So we have the HTML basic tags which is having their own functionality, okay? For example, say for example take suppose paragraph tag instructs the browser, hey browser, please put the text as a paragraph inside your screen, okay? So that is the basic functionality of the paragraph tag. If you want to convey to the browser some more information that hey browser, please display my text in the italic format in the color of blue, okay, that this functionality you want apart from the basic functionality as a paragraph, then what you have to do? So you have to do, in such cases what you should do is you will specify the attributes, okay? How we can see, we will see now, right? HTML attributes convey the additional information of an element, okay? And then these attributes are placed inside the opening tag. So where to specify the attributes means in the opening tag itself. So we will see one example so that you will understand it very well. And then HTML attributes are in the form of name and value pairs, okay? Attributes are always in the form of name value pairs, name and its value. So as a basic HTML attributes are like this: name is equal to value, and CSS name value pairs will be like this: name colon value, like this, okay? So let us see one example so that it will be understand to you very easily. For example, take a paragraph tag, basic paragraph tag. So you need to display this text, the content, my paragraph, as in a red color, and the font will be should be bold. If you want that functionality, then you need to specify that additional functionality as an attributes in the p tag itself, p tag opening tag itself, not in the closing opening tag. In the opening tag, after p, after the basic tag, the p is a basic tag now, so you have to give space and then you will specify the attributes. So here I specify is the CSS style attributes, okay? So CSS inline styling, so it is an other topic we will discuss in next classes. So style is equal to whatever you want, you need to give in the format like this: name and value. The name, so that's color, color is an attribute. That value, what you want read, you need to mention here. And then if you want more than one attribute, you need to give that attribute separated by this symbol, okay? Then font-weight. Font-weight means the font appearance, italic or bold or underlined, like that. So font-weight, it is bold. These are all the CSS name value pairs, friends, okay? So it is very famously used and frequently used styling. And then if you take the image tags, in the last class we saw how image tag works. So this is the basic tag. In addition to the basic tag, if you need to specify the image width and height, then you need to specify like this: source is equal to path of the image file on your computer, okay? So it is, it's not CSS style, but it is a basic name value pair. So name is equal to value, So this format you have to give. And then after that there is some space. After that width is equal to 200 and give some space, and height is equal to 300, like that. There is no separator required here, just give the space, that's it. So this is normal HTML attributes. And then anchor tag. Anchor tag is the basic tag, and this is an attribute. href is the attribute. So name of the attribute is href, and the value of the attribute is the website name. Okay, and this is the content. And like that, p means a paragraph tag. If you give the title attribute, then if you place your cursor onto the text content, then one pop-up will come, tooltip will come. So like that functionality will be added, okay, additional functionality will be added to that paragraph, friends. And the HTML tag will contain language attribute. So language attribute means if you want your a web page in a language of English, you need to specify EN. And specifically, if you want to specify English in which country, English or UK or US, like that, then you need to specify like this. Okay, so this is the attribute, and this is the total. It is an attribute, and the attribute is in the form of name and value. Okay, so language is the name, and this text inside the inverted quotes is called the value. Okay, so these are the some of the examples for HTML attributes. So the summary is what attributes means. It will convey some additional information in addition to the basic functionality to the browser. Okay, so that browser will understand. So I need to render this element as a paragraph, and then in order to the basic functionality, I need to color this text as red, and I need to display this text as bold, like that browser will understand. Okay, that is the purpose of the attributes, right? So in the next class we'll discuss about some more topics, friends. Till then, bye bye. Your Sveera signing off. Thank you for listening, friends.